wholeness comes from the totality of our person, of our being. And you have to have consciousness and unconscious in harmony. And I knew that mine were not in harmony. Well, I use the word masculine and feminine to describe two energies. And I do not make masculine synonymous with patriarchal. For me, patriarchal has become a parody of masculinity. It is a control issue. Control over other people, control over their own body, which will create the addiction, or power over nature. That's patriarchal. That is not masculine. This is not a new idea. I mean, in the Hindu world, they call it Shiva Shakti.
Right.
In the Chinese world, it's yin yang. In the religious world, it's transcendence and or immanence and transcendence. But I use these two words, masculine and feminine. I tried to get away from them. But I interpret dreams. So what I'm looking for in a dream is the balance of these two energies. And if that energy balance is out, then the personality is moving towards sickness.
Tell us then about the feminine qualities.
I would see the feminine as process instead of product, presence, being present here and now, not thinking about the future, not thinking about the past, but being here. That's something that's almost unknown in our culture. Receptivity, resonance, recognizing the rightness of something because it resonates in the body to the point, for example, where you get goose flesh, you mm-hmm. say, yeah, that's it, I got it.
On the other side, what are some of those masculine qualities that are within us all?
The real masculine, discrimination, discernment, looking at a goal, having the action that will move towards that goal, mm-hmm. Honoring the feminine, cherishing, working in harmony with it, creative, immense creative energy, which works, of course, with the creativity of the feminine. The two work together. You have to have both energies, as we have to have day and night. It's essential that both sides are working together for new life. If you believe yourself to be perfect, you believe yourself to be a god, and that is stupid. If you try to live up to what your parents may have put upon you, you know, that you are the darling little boy or you are the darling princess, you are going to look for a god, for a partner, and you are going to think of yourself as some kind of special creature. And sooner or later, that is going to collapse. I mean, you just have to look at the fundamentalists. It leaves the whole human side, which is not perfect, unlooked at. And sooner or later, that great energy will just come up and say, okay, look at me. So that you can strive for light and spirit and beauty and truth all day, go to sleep at night, and the addictive energy comes up.
What do you do if you love that dark side? In practical terms, just come to accept it? You say, well, that's me.
Yeah, but the dark side is beautiful. The feminine can be very cruel if you do not honor her, as the masculine can be cruel if it's not honored. But to love the juicy side of life, I mean, you know, it's to put a Madonna up on top of a pedestal, all white and all perfect and all nourishing, cherishing mother, that's to make her a goddess up on top of a pedestal.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about being a human being who loves being in the body, who loves to see the glory of spring, hear the glory of the birds, taste the glory of good food, to live the sexuality, you know, to know what it is to be human and love it, instead of trying to be a spirit that's going to take off in a UFO to go to heaven. The other side of the Virgin on the pedestal is the Mary Magdalene.
Sure.
And people don't mention that they have the other archetype, but many, many men have a wife and a mistress. And many women are equally split. They have one attitude towards themselves as wife and mother, a very different attitude toward themselves sexually. The Judeo-Christian tradition has left the feminine right split down the middle, so that we have the virgin and the whore. And that's in individuals, it is also in the culture. In the man, it can be split between the father and the Don Juan. Where the what you call the dark side is rejected, it will also manifest in the culture. So that there's something wrong with, in our culture, with being earthy, with being, really loving the body, honoring the rhythms of the body. Most people just think you're slow, a little bit stupid, and somewhat naive if you honor the body. I really do believe in the evolution of consciousness. And I do believe that there is a God, goddess, that the two together, I mean, I do not believe it's possible to separate the two. Mm-hmm. I think of God as a spirit and goddess as the manifestation of spirit. And you have to have both in order for either one to exist in our mentality, in our visualization. So I see these archetypes that are beginning to come in hundreds of dreams, thousands of dreams from all around the world, as the God trying to balance the feminine energy that has been lost right around the planet. The whole planet is into power. So how are we ever going to bring the feminine? Because you see, I've tried it in many meetings. I will say, look, I think we're going too fast here. Can we just please stop and look at what we're doing? And there's always that, oh, it's Marion again. And we'll just have to wait for her poor thing to catch up to where we are. I'm just sick of that attitude. Because what's happening, the mind is racing so far ahead of where the body is, and the body holds the feeling. So that you race in order to obliterate feeling, then it ceases to be human. I mean, the Nazis were a wonderful example. And it's now in our culture. You can just race to the point where there is no feeling, there is no humanity. The body moves much more slowly. And I think people who feel the feminine feel more than understand. It's feeling it. Your heart breaks when you see what people are doing to their own body, to their own children. I mean, what's happening in the schools, you know, where the creative world is being taken away because there is no funding for the creative arts, music, drama, and so on. And children are therefore taken away from their imagination. They're not given a chance to explore that. They're not given a chance to explore their creative efforts. So that immense energy which yearns for the creative, which is the masculine and feminine working together, mm-hmm. where the soul is given a chance to expand and to be, there is no room for that. But there's lots of money to build prisons.
If they come out, if society we do recognize the divine feminine more, what would change? How would society be different?
There would be much less action, a great more deal more faith in being. So many people, if I say to them, if they're divorced, and I say, well, why don't you just spend an evening with music in your apartment? They say, there's nobody there. I turn the lock, and it's just a black apartment. And I say, but you're there. Well, I'm nobody. That's the feeling. So that this sense of being someone, the beingness is the feminine. And the masculine takes that being into the world or into deeper levels of faith. It goes both directions, actually. And people would love their own creativity. They would honor the imagination that would allow them to create and express themselves. They would honor the earth. They would be able to relate without having to have power over. I mean, the whole world would just be turned upside down, that's the truth. Because people wouldn't have agendas for their children. You know, that the child should be this. It would take out the should, ought, and have to. So that the child would be given a place to flourish in its own personhood instead of trying to please somebody else. Because once you start a life of trying to please somebody else, then your whole life becomes pleasing somebody else until you have no life of your own at all. As women, for example, we find our femininity, we find the voice, which is connected to the depths. So instead of a voice coming from up here like this, like a little girl's voice, the voice comes from the depths of the womanhood. And when that happens in dreams, a brand new masculinity comes in to partner that. And the same thing happens in a man. The more masculine he becomes, the more the feminine begins to manifest in dreams.